Coach Derek Mason. Coach Mason, if you don't mind, just kind of start off with some brief opening statements, and we'll take questions from there.
I'll keep it brief. I'm glad to definitely be representing Vanderbilt University, Commodore football. Excited. It's that time of year. SEC Media Days, the kickoff to the college football season for us as we know it. And as I look at this team and where we're at, I believe the expectation is much higher than it was a year ago. We've moved in a different direction. As you look at our football team now, it's a much older football team with leaders, with depth. We have 42 returning juniors and seniors on the squad and some sophomores and a redshirt freshman who fully understand exactly what we're doing in this program. It's been great under the leadership of Andy Ludwig offensively to hone in on our skills, our depth, where we're at, where we need to get better. But Andy gets a full complement of players coming back, and the strength of Rob Webb is obviously evident, but I think the greater part of who we are and what we're doing now looks more like a collective group than what it is. We have seven tight ends now who are healthy, ready to go. We have seven running backs, okay, who are healthy. And a couple of those guys are flex combo guys in terms of playing fullback and tailback, which is outstanding for us. That's Andy being able to be Andy and utilize what we have in the toolbox, so to speak. Jeff Jennings brought a different culture to who we are on West End. Previously, Jeff was at Northwestern, Wisconsin, Cal. Jeff is a seasoned vet. He's been a head coach. But going against him at Cal and him developing guys like Deshaun Jackson in the return game and others, and coaching running backs at Cal and some of the guys that he had that have had a chance to go on coaching running backs at Wisconsin. That's important. So whether you're talking special teams, offense, I believe that culturally we are much better, in a much better space, place, and we have a chance to really show our mettle. Defensively, we're back. We're a group, obviously, with a lot of returning guys, some starters who I think can really start to cement exactly what this culture is on West End, playing great defense. And that's really been the guys. Yeah, I came back to defense. I understand how to call defense, but players play the game. I've never made a bad call. Guys make it right. And so with that being the case, I truly believe that these guys in their second year and being able to add some versatility to some of our defensive scheme structure is going to benefit our football team. But with that being the case, we look to play great football. RTI, relentless, tough, and intelligent. That's who we are. That's what we stand on. And with that, I'll turn it over.
Questions for Coach. Left side, third row.
Coach Ruffwood, you seem very confident about how your team will perform with what against South Carolina. Just what's your confidence level on this team going over the next couple of seasons?
Certainly not. These guys, James Dobson, my director of strength and conditioning, has spent the last 6 months grinding, pulling, really, kneading. I mean, just taking his hands and kneading, okay? This concept of team first attitude in this group. Okay, we have to play for one another. There are no stars on this team. When you look at it, we're a group of guys who are smart football or smart guys on West End who look to play better football. Ralph fully understands what we've done. Okay, what the days look like. And when I told this group, win days. And days become cumulative. We can win days, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. It leads to us having an opportunity to win Saturdays. Okay, we've competed, but we haven't won enough. Okay, winning is at the foremost of what we want to do on West End. So with that, let's move from the idea of we're smart kids on West End. We're good football players, and we need to prove that. We need to be that day in and day out. That's the expectation. That's what you'll see.
Right side, third row.
Derek, I wanted to ask you about Josh Smith. Can he be the missing piece of that linebacker core? He got a ton of experience, but can he kind of fill out that pass rushing role? And is that group now resembling those units you had in your last couple years at Stanford?
When I talk about Josh, I'm extremely excited about his growth and what he did. A year ago, he thought he was ready to play in the SEC, like all freshmen. They all think they're ready. You put him out there and they see the speed of the game, and it's like Neo in the Matrix. You know, they're taking punches from Mr. Anderson, trying to figure it all out. I think what he gathered by the time it was all said and done was that he could play. The speed of the game slowed down. Okay, and what I've seen in the offseason is his true abilities. He's reshaped his body, less body fat. Okay, he's mentally focused about his job. He's mad because he's not the starting guy. Okay, and that's just depth and iron sharpening iron. What it's done for the collective group is as these guys see themselves, they know and understand that you're only one false play, and waiting for somebody taking your job. That's the strength of having some numbers and being more competitive, inside, which makes you more competitive on the outside. So I'm fully ecstatic, where these guys have come from. They know and understand again what the expectation is, and it's a daily process, for these guys. So I like this linebacking core. Is shaping up to be. They want it, but there's a big difference between wanting it and getting it. And right now, we got to get it.
Also on the right side, third row.
Where do you think Ralph Webb stands amongst the SEC's running back elite, and why don't you think he necessarily gets some of the recognition that the rest of the guys get?
Well, Ralph is the best running back, at Vanderbilt University right now. He's the best on our roster, and that's all we really care about. Here's the thing. If you don't know about Ralph Webb, but then you haven't watched enough football, he's been able to do it with a makeshift offensive line. He's been able to do it with, guys who have had to fill roles, be young, grow up extremely fast, and he's never said boo. So I think it speaks more to his leadership and his competitiveness and how he's taking full advantage of being on a big stage. He hasn't had the full complement of wideouts to go downfield consistently. He hasn't had, tight ends to open up the middle of the field and keep backers out of the box. He's had to play with stacked boxes. He's had to play against, stiff competition with those guys, knowing exactly who they needed to key in on and what they needed to do to get us a critical third down situations. And he's been humble. He's been tremendously hungry in that process. And more than anything else, he's avoided the sophomore slump. So I think that tells you enough about who Ralph Webb is. If you want to see him play, come watch us play. 2016 will be a great season for him, and I fully expect him to step on the stage and be big.
Coach, we have time for one last question in the middle line.
Coach, you talked about your running backs, tight ends, and as you just gave us that, about the stack boxes and everything that your running back has to face. Now, your quarterback, can he consistently make plays so that the boxes won't be stacked as well, getting the ball to your tight ends and wide receivers?
I thought what you saw towards the end of the season was the maturation of Kyle Shermer. He's a young guy. Anytime you put a young guy in a hostile situation, he played well versus Tennessee. He was in a hostile environment with over 100,000 folks, and he found a way to get the ball down the field at Trent Sherfield. He found open windows. He made big plays on a big stage. We didn't help him out defensively, and that's on us. Okay, and that takes us not left our mouth. But what I will say about that is that this group has been continually chastised and pushed, and really talked about and talked to on a daily basis about what the expectation is. They can't run from it. There's nowhere to run. So we came up with the whole idea of what fear means. Fear everything and run, or face everything and rise. And so we look to face everything and rise. These guys will rise outside, inside, running backs, defense, special teams. That's who we are. That's where we are. I'm looking forward to seeing these guys play. But after the day, we're right back to work tomorrow morning at 5:15. So let's go.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.